Hair, 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 hair.
Boom.
Butter it, now we're ready to race. All right, on to pack a pickup. All right, the last item for the Pikes Peak Ascent just arrived in the mail from Amazon. Thank you, Amazon, for helping me out, getting it here quickly. And this package I'm not gonna open today. I will just say though, it is some items from Raid Light. That's right, my running vest is a Raid Light. Actually, it's right. I will not be using this in the Pikes Peak Ascent, but it's a Raid Light running vest. I do love it, but I have some updated gear that I will open up for you after Pikes Peak. Right now, I'm gonna open this up. I think you all, I mentioned what I bought a couple days ago, and yes, there it is. I love the Spring Energy Long Haul Gels. So there it is, it's a peanut butter taste. It tastes so good, and it's worked really well during this training block, and that's it. Okay, so in this vlog, we're gonna sit here, we're gonna break down my gear list, and there's gonna be a lot of tips thrown your way, but we are gonna lean into the veteran racers out there as well. Share your experience for packing for peak races down in the comments. I'm gonna ask the question of the day in a minute. But my first tip is definitely don't try new nutrition on peak race days. So I've been using these gels all summer long. I love them, they hit the stomach well. So I will be using one of these in the Pikes Peak Ascent, all right? Even though I ordered, I think there's 60 in here. So, and before I go any further, question of the day, veterans out there especially, but everybody, but especially those who have been racing for a long time, what is your one piece of race day gear that you cannot live without? Oh, I cannot wait to read these comments. I bet I'm going to see the comments and be ordering things tomorrow or the next day, because I know you have some good little items or big items that will be critical for race day. So thanks for hitting that up. And yes, gear is gonna be the key word. And so what is my strategy for packing for a peak race? Here it is. I start at the starting line. So all the gear and everything I'm gonna be using at the starting line, no more, no less, is where I begin to lay out on a flat surface that's nice and clear, not cluttered, and that's what you're looking at right now. I go grab everything out of my house and I just lay it out. Again, no more and no less. Why do I start there? Of course, because that's the most important. It's more important than the warm-up. It's more important than having comfy clothes on the bus ride home. It's more important than a lot of things. And of course, and I'll just put it at the top of the list, your racing shoes are the most important, and definitely, never ever pack your racing shoes under an airplane, or frankly, even under a bus. I would keep your racing shoes with you at all times. Your racing, like your racing flats, whatever shoes you're using, keep, and that's another tip for today, make sure they are with you all the time. Like a singlet can be replaced. Sunglasses can be replaced. Is it ideal? No. But so that's where I begin packing, and then from there, I go, so we start, so I have five steps for packing. I start with the starting line gear, then I move on to the warm-up gear, then I move on to the cool-down gear, and then I move on to the pre-race gear, meaning, okay, well, I'll get into that in a minute, and then I move on to the post-race, you know, party, hangout time, and drive back to your house or fly back to your house gear. So five different areas of gear that I'm looking at when I'm prepping for a peak race. Now I'm gonna run through exactly what I'm packing for the Pikes Peak Ascent. And again, if I was racing a road marathon, it would be a little different. If I was racing a 50-mile trail race, it would be quite a bit different. If I was racing a 5K road race, it'd be a little bit more simplified. So this is not gonna be exactly applicable to your race, but I think it'll give you an idea of how I formulate my race day gear. Okay, number one, starting line gear. Here we go. Bib number, which I don't have yet. I'm gonna pick up later today. Bib number, four pins to pin the bib onto your singlet. Singlet, shorts, race day socks, racing shoes, halo headband, remember that halo headband to keep the sweat out of my eyes, sunglasses, watch, gel, and a throwaway water bottle, meaning a bottle that you can just, you know, recycle, toss to the side, because I like to sip water right up until the gun goes. Just sip, not a lot, just to keep my mouth a little bit, not from drying out, basically. So again, bib number, four pins, singlet, shorts, race socks, race shoes, headband, sunglasses, watch, gel, and throwaway water bottle. Okay, so that is what I will arrive with on me to the starting line at the Pikes Peak Ascent. Okay, moving on. Number two, warm-up gear. Singlet, shorts, warm-up socks, warm-up shoes, anti-chafing salve, and foam roller. Okay, so as I park my car, I'm gonna put the anti-chafing salve on. I'm not gonna put sunscreen because by the time I'm done racing, it's gonna be, let's just call it, before 9:30. I'm just gonna say that much. And then warm-up socks. I like to start a race with fresh socks. So I change socks right before the race so they're not sweaty from the warm-up, okay? And then warm-up shoes, of course. And then the foam roller, just a gentle foam roll. Nothing aggressive, definitely not the trigger point foam roller, just the nice, actually, hold on. Definitely not the trigger point foam roller. You never know what could happen, you don't want that. So just a gentle foam roll on this guy. And then number three, cool down gear. A t-shirt, you know, a dry fit t-shirt. Fresh socks, cool down shoes, recovery tools, drop bag for sweaty clothes, and then if it's chilly, you know, a light jacket, light pants, hat, gloves. It could be chilly on top of Pikes Peak, absolutely. So that'll go into my drop bag for the top of the mountain, along with, yes, my phone, so I can call true love, so don't forget to mark that down. And I believe that's it for the top. Okay, oh yeah, and of course, any little goodies as far as snacks or something like a post-race snack that you want. Of course, most races have snacks for you, drinks, everything, beer, whatever, you know, there's a lot of things at the post-race these days. So that's cool down gear, that's number three. Number four, so I jump back to before the race. So these are in order of importance for me. Number four is the pre-race drive slash flight to the race. Long sleeve shirt for early morning coolness. You know, when most races start in the morning, so just a nice long sleeve shirt because it might be cool out. Comfortable pants, fresh socks, recovery sandals. That's right, I don't put my warm-up shoes on until I get to the start, until I get to the race area. I just wear my recovery sandals. And then, of course, my coffee mug, just a little bit of coffee, not too much, just a little bit of coffee for that pre-race drive down to the starting area. And number five, post-race hangout slash drive home gear. Long sleeve shirt, I like to actually put a flannel on if it's really chilly. And then comfortable pants again, fresh socks again, recovery sandals again, a hat, a big hat for the sun. If you're sitting out waiting for the awards to happen, sometimes a big sombrero can be amazing. Of course, your sunglasses, of course, your recovery tools, and then definitely hydration is key. So a nice, if you can keep it cold somehow, like a nice cold water or recovery drink, whatever you like to drink after a race. So that is number five, post-race hangout drive home gear. Okay, one more time in order for me, starting line gear, warm-up gear, cool-down gear, pre-race drive, post-race hangout slash drive home. So five steps for me for packing. And I'm not including, like, if you're going to Europe, if you're going somewhere far, you're gonna need to pack some more clothes. Like, that's, you know, we'll call that the civvies. Is that what the military, the civvies, I'm gonna leave that to you for what you wear around a city hanging out for a race to happen or after a race. So that is my race day gear checklist for the Pikes Peak Ascent. Actually, like, I'm serious. Like, I'm opening these springs right now and I'm gonna toss it over right now to the laying out on the table, and then I'm off to get a haircut and then go pick up my bib number. And then tonight I will actually, literally, it's crazy. I know this is crazy, but it really helps. Like, just pin your bib number onto your shirt, on your singlet the night before. It's just one last thing you have to think about before on race morning. When on race morning, you just wanna relax, drink a little coffee, have your little breakfast, whatever you eat on breakfast on race day, and then get in the car and just be nice and calm, and you don't have to worry about fumbling with the pins and all that stuff when you're still waking up. Okay, let's rock and roll. Off to a haircut. Actually, shall we do it? Hair. Boom. Butter it. Now we're ready to race. All right, on to pack a pickup. Thank you. Oh, baby, we're ready. We are ready now. Seth, number 103, there it is. Oh, that's exciting. It's like, there's nothing like getting your bib number, and getting it early helps as well, so I'm glad I came down to get it. And now I can just chill out and tonight pin it on my singlet. And yes, remember another tip I said a couple days ago, I like to have a little bit more of a pasta meal, carbohydrate meal, 2 days before the race. So I'm gonna go back home, have a spaghetti with the fam, and bada bing, bada boom. Let's do this. Oh, when you're watching this, it's a day to go. All right, see you at the spaghetti. And 103, we got
103. 103 is our lucky number.
Here we
103
are.
103 Seth.
Boom.
That looks good, babe.
Boom. What do you guys think? It says Seth on there.
And what's that MS?
I don't know.
Must.
I have no idea.
Surrender.
Must.
Joe Gray must surrender.
And eat my pasta, my big pasta dinner, bigger pasta dinner 2 nights before. And then tomorrow night I'll do more pasta, but just not a huge one like tonight.
Yeah.
I like to do it 2 nights before. So, all right, guys.
Your haircut looks sharp.
Oh, thank you. Appreciate that. Yeah. And most recently, I have given shout out to these vlogs in the past, maybe month, but I'm going to do it again. The two past filming experiences and races at the Pikes Peak Ascent on either side of the screen. All right. Seek beauty.
Work hard.
And love each other. See you tomorrow.